What's up, good people, and welcome to Masoni TV, your number one online TV show. Guys, it's yet another day, it's yet another weekend, an awesome weekend, maze, coming straight from this rail line. Guess where we are. Wase, we are still in Nairobi, tuko Embakasi, and today there are a lot of activities happening. As I told you earlier, Kenya is a busy country. It's a very busy country. After these, there is these and these and these. Now, after weeks and weeks of protest, now we have yet another big issue happening around Kenya. And all eyes, everything, the media, world is focused on that issue. And that issue is Kware issue. You guys have seen on TV, you've watched what's happening here at Kware. Kware is just miles away, like 5 kilometers from this point. So guys, I'm around pipeline area. This flyover is pipeline. I showed you flyover for stage Mpia or Feather. I showed you the one for Kware. Now this one is for pipeline area. So guys, just down there is Feather railway station. So guys, a lot has been happening around this place and around Kenya. So right about now, I made this video special since I come from these areas of Embakasi, and the Kware incident is just down here. Why not? I wanna take you there and let's see what's happening. Because the government has taken the issue upon themselves, and I'm guessing there is a lot of security beefed up down there. So we will try and see. We'll go there and try and see if we can find something, eh? Yeah, so guys, I want to take you to Kware. Meanwhile, before we go to Kware, I want to show you pipeline as we head downwards towards Kware. So guys, this is the pipeline main stage. Now this is the pipeline main stage. Yeah, this whole area is pipeline. And this road is outer ring road. So guys, you wanna get deep into pipeline as I go and show you around pipeline to the drainage. We go as I see you, as I show you pipeline, and then after there we head downwards towards the Kware area. But now, so guys, one thing about pipeline, so populated that I have to be very careful. There are a lot of people. We'll see as we go, as we do this video. Anyway guys, welcome to Masoni TV once again. Maze, if you're new to the channel, kindly subscribe. See, the business is booming everywhere. Kware residents are very busy. I'll be showing you the businesses that are going on here and everything that is happening. And remember, it's on a Sunday. But usually during weekdays, people are at work. These people work in Mombasa Road, industrial area, and even towns. So finding them during weekdays, sometimes it's hectic. So guys, we go as I show you around, as I show you businesses, structures. So many people think Kware is a slum. It's not a slum, man. This is an estate which is developing at a very faster rate, trust me. And it's a place you wanna come and live and raise your children in. So guys, let's head up there as I show you around pipeline, and we go finish our video at Kware. So guys, welcome back to Masoni TV. As you can see, these are the structures, maze. And as I was telling you, pipeline is so developed. Look at those beautiful structures. I don't know how we call this estate, but trust me, it's one estate that is so developed. And it's around pipeline area. It's around pipeline area. Some people think we are living in slums. This is not a slum, man. It's just that it's so populated, but it's not a slum. So pipeline is somewhere you can just come and coexist with your family, and you feel good. So guys, of late I've been using my mask. The reason to that, I went to protest and I sniffed that tear gas and it really affected me, and that's why nimekuwa na homa, I've been coughing, and that's why I try to put on mask so that I don't spread the flu to other people. Yeah, so that's why you've been seeing me with the mask most of the time, but at some point I remove it and we just do our video. Just the normal Masoni who shoots this video. There's nothing strange about it. So guys, let's head downwards. It's downwards. We are coming from these sides. Look at those structures, looking very nice. I remember the name of this estate, and I'll tell you as we continue the video. I remember, I know it. So as we continue the video, I'll be telling you the name of that estate. It's a very, how do you call it? It's a gated community estate. Yeah. So guys, this point we are heading, it's around Quickmart area in Pipeline, and I'm telling you, your place huko ngana wase, when you come here, mostly in the evenings, your place huko ngana wase, jamu ya wase, like even passing, sometimes it becomes harder, eh? So guys, we are approaching this Quickmart area. We want to head downwards. Look at that beautiful structure just ahead of us. Right ahead of us. So nice, man. We have like bedsitters, single rooms, and more one bedrooms. And it's, yeah, one major problem that Kware Estate experiences is a problem of water. That one I will not lie, eh? If you come here, you must be prepared to go and fetch water from a distance. Yeah, so you're my friends wants to appear on the video. What's up, man? Mkwaje? Kupoa? Wacha tupige kitu, sidia? Yeah. So one thing, one big problem we have here is a water problem. But the rest of the things like food and everything, so here we are here at Quickmart. We are here at Quickmart. We wanna head downwards as I show you. I can't really remember the name of this club, this one, but it was once banned. I think it's last year in Chomekanga. If you know the name of this club, Maze, just comment section Masoni TV, tell us the name of that club. Let me change my camera because of this noise, Maze. And then we keep heading downwards. Now we've just taken the... So guys, welcome back to Masoni TV. In Pipeline, the most populated estate in Kenya. This is the most populated estate in Kenya, trust me. So many people. Alafu, I'll say because of music. I was telling you guys, Pipeline is so populated. It has a lot of people. I wish you'd see these people. Ukikuja hapa jioni maze, the kind of people that you find here. So we are coming from Quickmart. And if you can see it, we are heading downwards towards Kware. We want to see what is happening here. And there's a lot which has been happening of late. We want to just know what is really happening at Kware. So guys, as we head down, I also want to take this opportunity to remind you to subscribe to Lady V Silas. You already know the spelling. L-A-D-I-E space V space S-I-L-A-S. Silas, I'm alone today again. It's now becoming a norm. Squeezing a tembea peke yangu, maze. Look at those structures. And then there is some this funny thing. Okay, kuna vile watu wana view Pipeline like it's an estate with full of clothes. Yeah guys, stay focused and concentrate on these buildings. You'll see the cloth lines everywhere. And you wonder how these people tie even those cloth lines on those buildings. What I can say, every estate has its own fair share of mabituko. So I'll be showing you as we go down. You'll be seeing, like, see on that building we have some clothes hanged around everywhere. This is a hospital in pipeline. Mission Care Nursing Home. It's a hospital here. Let me turn my camera and show you amazing things around this place as we head down. I'm going to pick a story polepole and kiwambia hii maneno ya kuhang manguo kwa buildings. And that's one thing we are known for. Like when you're passing outer ring road on the main road heading up or down, you will see clothes everywhere up a pipeline. So guys, stay tuned. Subscribe to Masoni TV, like, comment, share. We are almost hitting 1,000 subscribers. We are less 23 subscribers to go. And guys, as you can see where I'm coming from, there are a lot of people. And I'm telling you, mbele, kujaona, there are a lot of people. See, guys, eh? Tuko pipeline, maze, tuko pipeline presented, eh? I've always wanted to do a video here, and the Kware issue is a good reason for me to do this video. Guys, continue enjoying my videos. I was telling you about the tribes that lives around here. Wale wengi sana ni Kamba tribe. You know, in Kenya we have 42 tribes, 42 or 43 there. We have many tribes in Kenya. Just to mention a few, we have Luya, we have Kamba, we have Luos, we have Kikuyus, we have Kalenjins, and many others. So upper pipeline, you will find Luyas, you will find Luos, but the most dominant tribe here is Kamba. Kamba people, they come from Eastern, and Eastern is not far. It's not far. Like Machakos and Makueni and so on, name them. So they just come from Eastern, which is along Mombasa Road. And you know, it doesn't take them long to reach to Nairobi. Eh? Like from here to Machakos is around 150 Kenyan shillings. So these people, they come to pipeline, that is their first stop, and then maybe they find a job around this area. Let's say they are working in how do you call it, Mombasa Road industrial area, or this other side, in a tragic place, I'm forgetting, how do you call this place? We have anyway guys, as we continue the video, I'll be telling you the name of that place. And we also have some industries built there, so they find jobs there and they just come and live here in pipeline. So utapata mse ameka this place for like 5 years. He has never ajaifika Nairobi CBD. It's very possible you work here, you live here, so it's sometimes you don't have any business to do in town. So you find them wanaenda for more years without even stepping in town. Anyway guys, his only story is a pipeline. See the beautiful pipeline, maze. The cables, power cables, the data cables, crisscrossing everywhere. Look at that structure, maze. Look at that structure, maze. Clothesline, clothes hang everywhere. But again, as I told you guys, the only problem we have here is, and business is booming. We have food business here. Our moms are doing us justice. As you can see, business is good here. Very busy. It's a very busy estate. From Monday to Sunday, we just enjoy doing business here. So guys, we are coming. Let me just show you where we are coming from. As we continue heading downwards, we are coming from, if you can see, that's where we are coming from. And we are heading this downwards towards Kware. We just want to see what is happening there. For those who don't know, Kware has been trending of late. Let me turn my camera and explain to you what has been happening here. So guys, for those who don't know, Kware has been trending of late. It's because allegedly people have been killed somewhere else and dumped around Kware. At Kware, the reason why we call it Kware, it's supposed to be called quarry, because they used to some European used to dig some quarry around there. So when they left a very big hole where they used to dig that quarry, or that quarry, a big hole. So what has been happening, people are killed from different parts of Kware, or different parts of pipeline, or even in Nairobi, different parts of Nairobi, and then they come and dump them at Kware. So of late, there is this lady who dreamt of, this is how the story began. There is a lady who lost her sister in a mysterious way, that there is some guy who came and called her sister and then left with her sister, and she never saw her sister. Now this lady, it's been a while, she never saw her sister. The number is off, her sister's number is off. So what she did, okay, not what she did, her sister allegedly died. You know, in Luya community, we believe in dead spirits, that you can communicate with them, they can tell you what's happening, you know, they foretell the future. So the dead sister, allegedly, not yet confirmed, the dead sister has been bringing dreams to this other sister. Now the sister who dreamt, like, anamletea ndoto, like, I'm somewhere else, I'm in a cold, you guys need to come and rescue me, I'm in a hole, I'm inside water. This is through dreams, guys. I don't know if it happens wherever you come from, but you can share hapo kwa comment section, let's know. So this lady has been dreaming about her sister, allegedly about her dead sister, and so she decided, let's start with quarry, let's check her in that hole, in that hole they dug to mine quarry. So guys, a number of boys and ladies went to that quarry, or went to that hole, to try and see if they can find the dead sister. Man, when they went there, the imaginable happened. So they've been retrieving bodies wrapped in sacks, cut in pieces and wrapped in sacks, dumped in those holes. So as I'm doing this video, they've already recovered 11 bodies, and today is their third day of recovery, and we're just going to see what is going to happen there, if they'll retrieve more bodies, or the bodies that were there were just 11. And these are bodies of female, the girls, young girls, killed, their bodies dismembered and wrapped in bags, maze. Unyama, unyama, unyama. We condemn that act of it's very, very bad to do that to a fellow human being. Anyway, guys, I hope you guys are seeing my town, my estate, beautiful pipeline estate. Yeah, business as usual is booming. Yeah, we have chemists, we have hospitals here, we have schools around here, we have so many things around here. So here, business, markets, we have almost everything. The only maybe thing we need to go for in towns is to get these things we are selling here. But otherwise, pipeline, quarry, feathers, tejimpia is a business house on its own. A business house on its own. So guys, this is my estate. Basically, this is my estate. This is my estate. And this is not This is just part of pipeline. I'm telling you, we still have some other businesses going inside there. We have here things called bypass, like that one is passing towards the other end. So we have things called like some tupanya routes where you just get in here and you unatokea the other side. So it's big, it's super big. This part I'm shooting is I think the most busiest part of pipeline, is the most busiest part. And you guys, as you can see, maze, the cloth line kama kawaida, nguo ziko hanged up everywhere, everywhere. So guys, welcome to Masoni TV, and let's do this. Remember to subscribe to Lady V Cyrus. I only need 25 subscribers, maze, 23 to be precise, to hit 1000 subscription mark, and we call it a day. So guys, hii place niko ndio njia inaingia stage mpya. Stage mpya, like stage mpya, for those people who've heard about stage mpya. This stage mpya is just behind us in there. So guys, we continue doing this. Sorry. I'm telling you, pipeline is so populated, and we have a lot of people around here. You guys can bear me witness because you've seen them, and we have some nice structures. As you can see, we have some very nice structures to accommodate all these people. I think the reason why we have shortage of water in a pipeline, it's because of the population around this place. Let's say the amount of water that is supposed to distributed here, anyway, nisingie huko sana, but I think, my thinking is because of the population around this place, and because of that we have a very big issue. This is another supermarket, it's called Muzuri Store Supermarket. It used to be called Capital Supermarket, but I think they changed their name to Muzuri Store Supermarket. So guys, I'm still heading down towards Kware. I'm leaving the pipeline part of it, stage mpya part of it, and further. Now we are heading downwards towards Kware. We are heading downwards towards Kware so that we can see kitendawili inaendelea huku hivi maze. So guys, tafadhali, niko home, show me some love maze, show me some love, subscribe to this channel maze, watch my videos. Right now we are chasing something called watch time or watch hours maze. The more you watch maze, the more I'm almost there maze. Continue supporting me so that I can continue bringing you these amazing videos, these amazing travel videos, so that you can also enjoy at the comfort of your sofa set, or at the comfort of your beautiful apartment or house maze. And I hope most probably from Kware, watu wa Kware if you're watching, watu wa pipeline if you're watching maze, support your brother. The channel is Masoni TV, M-A-S-O-N-I, and let's do this maze, Space TV. So guys, karibuni tena. I really wanted to show you the route that goes to stage mpya, but there were some guys who were standing there. If I had just turned my camera, maybe they could have thought we were filming them. So that's why I tried to avoid that. But the point I was is the same point that leads to stage mpya. It's a very busy cloth market, especially on weekends. Guys, allow me to put on my mask because I'm not feeling well. So continue enjoying the scenes and sceneries of Kware. Yeah, here we have everything, almost everything. We have hospitals, we have like the mission care I show you just behind there. We have chemists where you can find medicines. We have schools. We have also good roads. We also have good roads, maze. So business is good here, like you can be sure. This is an estate you can come, rent, and educate your kids just around here and even do business here. We also have zile joints za maboys. Okay, I've just noticed that with this thing, I'm not loud enough. So kuna zile joints za maboys, zile maboys who relax na kujibamba, like restaurants, pubs, like behind me, wanashukisha cakes, cakes kwa gari. So pia huku ni kuna mita, at those points you can just have your drink and enjoy, you understand? You can watch a movie, name them. It's a all in one. So guys, I'm approaching Kware, and this place personally I fear it, because the boys of this place they don't joke, man. So forgive me if I'll not show you everything, but I'll try my level best to show you everything. But this place we are heading to, it's not a joke, man. But I'll try everything. I'll try my level best to show you at least a glimpse of what is happening or of what has been happening. So this is our temporary dump site. We have many along this road. This is one of them. This is where we store our takataka, and then the kanjo cars or vehicles, we come and collect them to go and dump them somewhere else. So that is one of them just behind me there. So I think now we are officially in Kware. Officially in Kware, but it's still in pipeline. This whole area is called pipeline, but ikona tule tumajina Kware, Stage Impia, Feather, name them. So we are officially in Kware. Continue enjoying the show, guys. Enjoy the show. Subscribe, like, comment, share, maze. Road to 1,000 subscribers, and we're almost there. Some few subscribers to go. Yeah, your number one online TV show. These sites are not as busy as where we are coming from. Like you will see, you will notice the population has gone down kidogo. I think most people on Aishuko Jo. That's what I think. Or they've gone down there to see what is happening. So welcome back again, guys, to Masoni TV, your number one online TV show. So guys, kwa kifupi tu, let's talk a little bit about the protest in Kenya. The protests in Kenya were engineered by bad governance. You understand? Like they were fueled by bad governance. Of late, our administration or our executive has been lying a lot on development agendas. Even their manifesto, they've never implemented even a thing. So what has been happening? They introduced a bill to us, a bill that was meant to tax Kenyans, even these Kenyans who are struggling with these small businesses. They were to tax them. We call them mamamboga here in Kenya. They were to tax almost everything. So there is this group, age group of this generation called the Gen Z's. Gen Z's are people who are around at most 25 years or 26 years. So this group warned the executive. They told them, enough is enough. If you don't withdraw the bill, you're gonna face the wrath of the people. And indeed, the power belongs to the people. I came to realize that the power belongs to people. If people decide today whatever they want, they will just get it. So people went to the streets, they protested, and hopefully it bore some fruits, because the bill was withdrawn and life continued. Now again, another demand for the Gen Z's. Yeah, so guys, I'm telling you, Niko Kware, and this side is not a joke, man. It's not a joke, you see. what is happening. They are telling me Tuesday is another Maandamano day. So the next demand that they wanted was to for president to dissolve the cabinet. And trust me, it happened. I'm telling you, the power belongs to the people. It happened. The president dissolved the government. And again, they still have a lot of demands. Now they want the whole system quashed. Or the whole system... Okay. So now their next demand is for the government to do away with the parliament. So basically what they are trying to say is, we want a fresh election. We want all the leaders elected to be sent home so that we can organize a new election and we elect new leaders. They are tired with this leadership. Sorry for that. So guys, I want to end this. The next video you'll see is at the quarry itself. I want to end this one here and continue later when we are at the quarry. But basically, I've shown you the pipeline estate. I've shown you everything that happens here, the business, the schools, the roads and everything, health-wise, business-wise. I think I've shown you everything, the building, the structures. You guys have seen everything. So the next thing is to go to the main point, which is the retrieval of the bodies. I hope it still continues so that I can go there and show you what is happening. Anyway, thank you guys for keeping it Masoni TV. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you for liking. I love you guys. See you at the quarry, Maze. See you at the quarry. Hi guys, welcome again to Masoni TV. We are at that point, Maze. We are nearing the quarry police station. And at the point where all this drama is happening. I'm seeing a lot of people, Maze, pale mbele. Let's go and try and do a video there. But I'm afraid these youths, I fear these youths, Maze. So, tukutane pale, Maze. We are almost at the quarry police station.